each news time, information is power. Be current. The news headline. The arrest of a deadly bandit leader, Alhaji Gumar Sumaila, who pleaded for forgiveness. The news in full. By their nature, the elements of banditry who have made both the northwestern and some part of the north central Nigeria war zones are dangerous, heartless, and inhumane. They have not even a single iota of pity for the human life, and with their knowledge and level of wickedness, that has become a question that begs for an answer if their Boko Haram and ISWAP terrorist counterparts are really more dangerous than they are. It was in the light of this that Nigerians of all walks of life, and both within the country and the diaspora, had to mount pressure on the federal government to declare them terrorists, like the foregoing two groups, in order that they may be thoroughly tackled as well. This is why the judgment that was passed by Justice Taiwo Taiwo of the Abuja-based Federal High Court, in which he eventually pronounced them so on the 26th of November, was a commendable one. The recently proscribed bandits, like every other normal association of people, also had leadership echelons, albeit they are scattered all around the forest where they operate from. Thus, they have overall leaders, their assailants, and others. One of such so-called leaders was a certain Alhaji Gumar Sumaila, who was reportedly captured on the 9th of 24th of Friday, September, in Kaduna State. Before his arrest, the Alhaji bandit leader was said to be rated among the categories of the likes of Toji Kakala, Alilu Sububu, and now late Dogo Gide as the most dreadful and wanted criminals in the country. That was because of their notoriety in their banditry activities in Zamfara, Kaduna, and Katsina State, where they allegedly indulged in kidnapping, cattle rustling, armed robbery, and destructions of life and property. However, in his confessions upon his apprehension, after admitting his culpability to the crimes, Sumaila went on to plead for mercy and that he would not go back to criminal ways if he should be forgiven. And according to him, he said the truth, because whoever said the truth is in one accord with God, and therefore the arrest of the deadly bandit leader, Gumar Sumaila, had actually given the military men another edge to ensure that they put a stop to the banditry activities going on in Kaduna State, Katsina State, and also Zamfara State, where there is a high level of kidnapping, cattle rustling, armed robbery, and also destructions of life and properties. And this is also to continually motivate the security agencies not to give up and continue to do what is just and right in saving the lives of the citizens. Legislative and judicial arms of the government are also focused on managing the cost of governance, noting that government is a collective and is not the business of executive arm of government alone. He said the adoption of the National Ethics and Integrity Policy by the Federal Executive Council has led to some public offers demonstrating the core values of ethics, integrity, and patriotism, who have also been identified for their sterling anti-corruption disposition in their workplaces. The president presented the 2021 Public Service Integrity Awards to some Nigerians, notable among which was one Ikenna Steve Nweke, the Nigerian PhD student in Japan, who found a wallet containing a very large amount of money, another valuable risk returned to the Japanese palace. He declined 10% of the money offered to him as a reward, to which Buhari said, "I am always happy to note that the ICPC Special Award to Ikenna Steve Nweke, a Nigerian PhD student from Imo State studying in Japan. He has done Nigeria proud in faraway Japan by displaying traditional Nigerian values of honesty and integrity, which he did by returning a wallet containing a very large sum of money and other valuables to the police. I joined the ICPC in declaring him ICPC Citizens Anti-Corruption Volunteer Group Icon. He is indeed an icon and a beacon for our youth. I also congratulate all those to be awarded the ICPC Certificate of Integrity through their agencies." And this is the news about President Muhammadu Buhari trying to talk about the areas of which the government of Nigeria under its leadership has actually done their utmost best, to focus on the prosperity of the nation. Where the president also said that he was going to sanction those who bring in personnel into the public sector without due process, saying that there are a whole lot of people that has been discovered that are ghost workers, and all these corrupt practices are part of the things that are affecting the stability of the nation. Where the president says that for everyone that is being recruited illegally and their payroll, is being padded with them being ghost workers, that very soon the all will be caught. And the president stated this while delivering the third national summit on diminishing corruption in the public sector in Abuja, and the event was actually organized by the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Related Offenses Commission, ICPC, and they have drawn stakeholders from public and private sectors on the team to come and deliver and how to eliminate corruption for better service. The president warned his administration that they would not hesitate, to punish anyone out of the stakeholders, in the public sector, the head of ministries, the departments and agencies, the MDAs, any one of them that fraudulently, partake in these corrupt practices will be made to face the law. And also, particularly, there are some agencies and departments that have been presenting fraudulently new projects as ongoing projects in the budget. And according to the president, his administration has focused on security, economy, and fight against corruption since 2015 with considerable success. So, all those who are fraudulently presenting new projects as ongoing projects in the budget, they are actually going to be figured out as soon as possible and they will face the wrath of law. President Muhammadu Buhari noted that despite immense potential in the country, it has been handicapped by corruption, imbalanced economy, and also insecurity. And while he was speaking on the cost of governance, he said his administration was able to reduce the cost by maintaining their promise to complete abandoned or ongoing projects commenced by previous administration, and that they have ensured that the MDAs do not put forward new capital projects at the expense of ongoing ones. According to President Muhammadu Buhari, says that the ICPC and some MDAs have devised the fraudulent practice of doing that, and that necessary actions and sanctions will continue against the heads of such errant MDAs, and that his confidence that the ICPC will continue to maintain the vigilance required of by the ICPC Act in this regard, he said. Thanks for listening.